to be a fly on the wall of the Warner Brothers DC development room. I wonder if there's a single person working there who actually has read the comics. Or likes them. Are they just forcing themselves to flip through them and they're like, we're never going to get through all these stories. Let's just flip through them quickly and kind of take bits and pieces here and there. It sounds a little bit like what they're doing. But anyway, a lot of DCEU rumors swirling around today, and I checked with my sources. They got back to me after a little bit, because they had to do their own checking. And I'm able to clarify the two rumors of the day for you. All right, so number one is Warner Brothers developing a rebirth reboot movie, right? No, they are trying, though, to think of a way to fix a lot of their continuity problems in one fell swoop, which is I'm not saying someone wasn't talking to another their source, and that source might have been like, you know, it's like rebirth, it's like a reboot. So, you know, sometimes that happens. So, I mean, I heard they're not specifically making a rebirth movie. Like, no major Warner Brothers exec is like, let's do rebirth. They're like, man, is there a way we could fix this horrible ball of knots that we have in one fell swoop? And so it's basically a reboot type situation. And I guess if you were talking about DC reboots, you could say rebirth. But you could also say the New 52, which was the first time that DC Comics decided to reboot their continuity back in 2011. They were like, oh, we want new people to read comics, but it's so hard to have read all the old comics that have come out for decades. Why don't we kind of do a soft reboot where you could start from right now with the New 52 and you feel like you're all caught up, right? And so they just did in one fell swoop, they did away with all of the classic, wonderful stories that have been told and made DC Comics what it is today. Who would do that? It's so stupid. But they did it. And the sales were great to start. Every comic book fan wanted to see it. Some new people said, okay, let me take a look at this thing. But then, wham, they ran right into a wall and it was a horrible disaster. And ever since then, the comic book publisher, DC, has been trying to fix that mess. Rebirth was one such attempt to fix that mess. So if you want to use DC lingo for a reboot, it would be New 52 or Rebirth. Although New 52 is a lot harder to explain to a movie audience than Rebirth. That's a better word. And then there's the upcoming Generations, by the way, which may or may not happen. We'll see. But it's rumored that DC Comics will have a new generation take on the iconic mantles of the Justice League. And it's funny, I just made a video about the MCU doing that earlier today. The MCU's been around for a decade, and for the most part, has really taken the time to introduce audiences to the characters who will be taking over. These characters in the comics are just going to come out of nowhere. Generations is a rumor. I think DC's still tinkering with it because they know it's a bad idea, and I can tell you right now, it's a horrible idea. I think it would be really hard to read a Batman story where someone else was Batman unless it was Damian Wayne or Dick Grayson. And, you know, two people who have, by the way, in comics been Batman. But I think after a while, of course, you always want it to go right back to Bruce Wayne. It's just the way it works in comics and the way people want to hear these stories. It's just the way it is. Sorry, comic book publishers in Hollywood. I know it's not what you want to hear, but it's the way things are. So I think this is a bad idea, and I knew New 52 was a bad idea from when I first heard about it, but DC Comics did it anyway. And when you think about it, DC Comics and DC movies are actually a lot alike in terms of being an absolute mess. I would think that if one house got themselves in order, maybe it would help the other, but at this point, maybe they're just too far gone. I don't know. This is a real mess. But anyway, of course, in terms of reboots, there's also Flashpoint, which was recently used to reboot the DC animation storyline with Justice League Dark Apocalypse War. And Warner Brothers is contemplating a fix with the Flash, to use the Flash to accomplish it. But as we also recently discussed, it might not be the Flashpoint storyline that you all know and love. That's right. Bye-bye, Thomas Wayne, and the entire story. Because basically, if Michael Keaton says yes, I wonder what's taking... He might have already said yes. They might be waiting to announce it at DC Fandom. But, I mean, what else is Michael Keaton doing, quite frankly, right? I mean, I don't... You know, he's not working. If he's the face of one of the worst ideas in movie comic book history, that's at least interesting, and he'll make a lot of money doing it. So anyway, I don't think that's like a big concern in terms of how Michael Keaton feels about life. So, if he says yes, The Flash, it seems, from what I'm hearing, will run through all the old DC movies. I suspect Ryan Reynolds' current Green Lantern negotiations are not just about the Snyder Cut returning for a cameo there, but also to appear in this upcoming Flash movie. To create a big event film with a lot of like big guest stars, big names, that will go head-to-head with Doctor Strange 2, the Multiverse of Madness, which was being reversed the same year, and, you know, I think will be difficult to compete with. And I can see a studio executive feeling these are the same, but yet a comic book fan understanding that they are not. Alright, so in the end, the DCEU will be forever changed after the Flash is romped through all the old DC movies. I don't know how this might not end up being somewhat insulting to the former films. I don't know. We'll see. And one way that things would change is that Michael Keaton's Bruce Wayne would come back with the Flash to the current timeline, which has led to speculation that Batman Beyond is being developed for a movie. And the answer to that, as I found out today, is kind of. Now, maybe someday, years from now, Warner Brothers might make the futuristic Batman Beyond movie that so many of you crave. But as for what they're planning right now, again, if Michael Keaton says yes, he won't train Terry McGinnis, he'll train Barbara Gordon. I know, I know, I know. But I'm not only hearing this from my sources, but as you also might remember, when Deadline first reported Michael Keaton's potential deal, they specifically said he would show up. They said he'd be like Nick Fury, and he would show up in many DC films, including, they name-checked specifically, a Batgirl movie. And when we saw that, we were like, how the heck would that work? And then we just chalked it up to Warner Brothers being crazy. But it seems that this is how it would work. He would train Batgirl, not current Batman. Well, actually, this is a little frustrating to me. Why can't Barbara, first she got Birds of Prey taken away from her, and now she's going to get trained by Bruce Wayne? In the comics, Bruce Wayne doesn't even want her to be Batgirl. She has to do it herself. And she, you know, she's not wanted. And she has to prove herself. She's a real self-starter. And I am a little frustrated that will be taken away from her. So annoying. Next, you won't get shot. What is happening here? All right, so anyway, that's apparently what they're thinking. And if you think like a studio executive who, again, doesn't read the comics or respect them, I can see this make sense. Or if they were coming from someone from the outside, with like what Christina Hodson did with Birds of Prey and Margot Robbie did with Birds of Prey. Don't worry, we're going to talk about Christina Hodson in a second, because she's a big part of this. But, you know, it's like someone coming in and being like, oh, you know what would be cool? And just like running ramshod through your stuff and making a mess of it. I'd said Birds of Prey was like watching someone else play with your toys who had no idea what they were. And while you appreciate their love for the toys, they're doing it wrong. And I think that seems to continue to happen. And it makes sense that it would maybe come from Christina Hodson, who's playing with our toys and is really not doing a good, she doesn't know what she's doing. I mean, I'm not saying she's not having fun and isn't well-intentioned, but it's a problem. So anyway, as for this makes sense. They already have Pattinson coming up, right? Batfleck over on HBO Max. And now Michael Keaton's OG Bruce Wayne's going to be walking around. I don't know how they're going to explain that, quite frankly. I think it's going to seem laughably ridiculous the way things are right now in the DCEU. But why add a fourth Batman to the mix when you could have a female character, a female member of the Bat family, finally, right? Not since Alicia Silverstone, and she doesn't count because she was horrible. But, you know, although look what they did to Cassie Kane. Look how they massacred my girl. But, you know, you'd have a kick-ass female Batman, Bat family character. I'm sure a studio executive loves that idea. And this would make her different from not just Batman, but also Robin. And even better from a studio executive's perspective, she would basically be Bat Iron Man with the suit that Batman Beyond has. She'd be like Rescue, kind of. And I have to say, Rescue looked really cool. I'd like to see more of Rescue. So here's Bat Rescue. Also, you'd have shades of the iconic relationship between Batman and Carrie Kelly in Frank Miller's The Dark Knight Returns, pairing a female member of the Bat family with a much older Bruce. Now, I've seen the casting breakdown for the original or the last script that Christina Hodson wrote for it, right? She's, I can't believe it. Also, I don't know why Warner Brothers is hiring her so much. I mean, she's a hot screenwriter in Hollywood. Her spec scripts are very popular, but they've yet to produce a successful film. I think that would be a clue to someone. But anyway, the breakdown, and she's also the writer on The Flash, by the way, so we'll talk more about that in a second. But it included Barbara Gordon and also Jim Gordon, but a different one than Jeffrey Wright's for Pattinson, which is also ridiculous. But so again, this all depends on Michael Keaton saying yes. And I would imagine while they wait for him to say yes, these scripts haven't been rewritten yet. I think these are just ideas that they've had over at Warner Brothers for both the Flash and Batgirl movies, because why would you do all this extensive rewriting? Because you can't do it without Michael Keaton. He has to say yes. And I think he he will. As I said, why not for Michael Keaton? What does he care? Now, is this all Christina Hodson's idea, since she's the writer on both films, right? Is she like, I'll fix it? I mean, it does seem like the kind of continuity shredding that she did with Birds of Prey, which resulted in the least successful DCEU movie to date. Now, as I've just outlined it for you, I think this will get attention, that's for sure, and I think some people might even really like it. Some people really love Birds of Prey. But overall, I feel it's too confusing and silly for general audiences and too infuriating for DC fans. And I think it will eventually flame out, just like all the comic book reboots before it. Reboots are very difficult to do. I mean, just ask Terminator, right? I mean, once things are a mess, it's very difficult to right that ship, which shows that you should make more of an effort at the beginning so you don't have to reboot at all. I mean, I'll watch these movies because I'm a hardcore DC fan, but I can't see these movies having the kind of four-quadrant appeal that are necessary for a franchise like this. So that's the current plan. Remember, there are a lot of moving parts here. We'll see what Michael Keaton says. He's in the center of all this. But this is what Warner Brothers is considering right now. What do you think? Share your thoughts down below. You know, get out your frustrations. This is a safe space for you to discuss it. Share those thoughts down below. Subscribe today. And of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.